Welcome to Chapter 1 of your World Regional Geography online course. This chapter is entitled Introduction to the World, and that's exactly what this chapter is going to be about. It's introducing you to the different realms of our world, and our planet as a whole unit, and introduce the ideas and the foundation of geography. Most of my life, when I was in college, geography was kind of entitled, especially when you're doing like trivia night, is the facts, states and capitals and stuff like that. And that's true. That does have a lot to do with what geography is. But geography is a lot more than that. It's really the science that understands the whole big picture. So when I think of geography, I think of the word why. Why are boundaries designed the way they are around countries? Why are the continental slopes and rises around continents the way that they are? Or why do earthquakes happen in certain areas and not others? Why is language distributed a certain way, or religion or politics? So it really becomes this bigger, this aspect of questioning. And the big piece is that within geography as a social science, is that it's really critical thinking. Often people think when you hear the word critical, it means it has like a negative connotation, but it really isn't. To be critical is to ask the right questions to get the best answer. It's not to be harsh or any form of negative way. It's just like, well, I want to know all the facts. I want to know both sides. I want to know why certain states are red and blue. What are the numbers and the population densities of those types of politics? Why do people vote a certain way? Why do people practice particular religions? It becomes a really big piece of understanding world problems and understanding world interactions and reactions. We find, especially going forward, that this idea of cultural geography, especially from a global perspective, is becoming really important in the workplace, about being sensitive to certain cultures and diversity. A lot of companies are hiring geographers to learn about the area in which that they're trying to operate. Maybe certain cultures require certain types of clothing or certain types of breaks for religious reasons, or the list is huge. And to be sensitive and to be understanding and knowing of this is really what this is about. So, to kind of back up and then move forward again, this chapter is introducing you to the world, introducing you to the sciences that we look at. We look at spatial analysis, looking at data. We love data as geographers. We want to look at numbers of population densities. We want to look at gross domestic income. We want to look at net values. We want to look at just population decrease, increase. The list, it's just almost frazzling as to how much information that we want to look at. But by doing that, we're able to then put it together, project it into a map, and to be able to explain it to an audience. And then what's really interesting about GIS, which is Geographical Information Systems, is that we're able to put this data into a computer program that can then predict. It can say, based on current trends, this is what's going to be popular, or this is what we are going to expect in the future. Based on current trends, this is the type of population increase or decrease an area is going to experience. Or based on this type of information, this is what the average income should be based on these different outside input and push factors. We look at earth science. Earth science is really broken into the values of just, what do we stand facing and why does it look the way it does? Was it involved in tectonics? Was it involved in glaciers? Was it involved in flowing water? Was it involved in climate change, by one way or another, by becoming very hot or becoming very cold? We look at areas and regional locations and landscapes, and then we look at the human landscape. That's really something I really enjoy. We offer a class called California Geography that really talks about the human landscape. Well, what's the human landscape? Well, what type of designs are we as humans leaving on the landscape? So when you think of, say, the Central Valley of California, what type of landscape do you expect to envision? Well, you're looking at wineries, you're looking at the tall cypress trees, you're looking at agriculture, or if you're thinking about the cultural landscape of a place out in the Midwest, you're going to think more cowboy, more rustic, lots of wood, things like that. Well, those are implementations of human interaction with the environment. And when we start talking about landscape design, and not landscape such as like your garden, but just more of a cultural landscape, it becomes quite fascinating. You know, think about the discourses or the things that you know that you don't even know you know. You know, when you look at an old building and go, that old building, I bet that used to be a Taco Bell, or that old building looks like it used to be a Kmart or a Sears, or you know, you start to learn the landscape and you start to interpret it, and then you understand its historical patterns. And that's what this is about, is how do we look at regional places around the world and understand what type of landscapes have been human designed and what was the historical impact in the future. Bring it more, you know, relevant to today is think about walls. You know, the Great Wall of China, the walls between particular borders, whether it be the Berlin Wall or anything in between. What did that do to a cultural landscape? What did that do to the economics? What did that do to the language? What did that do to the families and the sensitivity along those pieces? It's not just building a wall to separate people. What else does it separate? What does it stand for? And then looking forward, what does it mean for the future? So that's really what this is about, is kind of introducing you to the bigger picture of what it is that geography is and how does it relate to a global perspective with the cultures thereof. I'm really excited and about this course and excited for you to work through this. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out. Otherwise, we'll talk soon.